So what is an operator and a scanner, and how do you do DPS to the fuses? Let's talk about that in this guide. And again, this is Part-Time Guardian. If this video provides value to you, feel free to like it, the video, and subscribe to the channel. I really appreciate it. So my raid guides are going to be a little bit different than others. Many creators will do one of two things. They'll either put up a quick guide where it's their Twitch stream and it's not very informative, or they'll put a really long video that goes into everything with maps and very detailed directions. I do something in the middle. Raids are very messy, and often you're not going to understand the details until you actually see them. So what I recommend is don't watch my video at first. Go into the raid encounter, kind of play around, see kind of what things feel like, and then come back and watch this video. And then as you wipe, come back and watch it again. Watch it a couple times. And again, that way you'll get a feel for it. I feel that sometimes when you make perfect videos and people expect to go in the raid perfectly with knowing every mechanic, I actually think it kind of breeds kind of the issues we have in the community with everything being know what to do and everything. Again, it takes some time, not just watching a video. It takes actual repetitions before you're good at encounters. So again, I want to encourage that with my videos. In this encounter, there are a few roles that come up frequently in the raid. One of those is operator, and one of those is scanner. The operator performs actions called out by the scanner. In this case, the operator for this activity, the operator will be punching keypads to open doors, and then keypads in a below area to open fuses to allow DPS to advance to the next phase. The scanner will be looking through holes in the floor to tell the operator which keypads to punch. The encounter is divided into three areas. If you're facing towards the area where the raid banner is and where you spawned in, we would call that, so in other words, you're at the back of the room and you're facing that way, we divide those into right and left and then the below room. You can also call this black and white and below, or again, whatever works for you. You need to divide into two groups of three, one in each of those top rooms. There are a series of fuses in the room that you need to destroy to complete the counter and that you can't access at first. There are also augmentation terminals, one of each in each of the three areas, so one on right, one on left, and one below. To start the encounter, one of your fire team members needs to go to an augmentation terminal and pick up the operator role. Once this occurs, all three areas will be sealed off. So again, make sure you're in your respective area you need to be in. Adds will spawn, including a series of servitors that must be killed or you will not be able to transfer the roles between the different areas, and we'll talk about that a little bit more in a minute. A vandal will spawn that will have the scanner role in one of the areas. In all my runs, it was in the area on the top, opposite of where the operators had picked up theirs to start. The scanner, once he gets his role from the vandal, will go to the holes in the bottom of the floor and look for yellow keypads that the operators will need to punch. Again, those are below, but you have to see them through the floors. In each area, there are a total possible of five, but you're only gonna have two on each side, two on left and two on right. What we did is we labeled these L1 through L5 and R1 through R5 for left and right rooms. Again, we started the numbering from the front of the room where you spawn in descending order. The keypads are either on one of the pillars in the below area or on one of the walls, but within visible sight of the various holes. Now, in some cases, you kind of have to look around because some of them aren't immediately obvious. So I would take some time as a scanner, familiarizing yourself with where those are. Again, as I said earlier, there are two keypads that the operator will have to punch, two on the left, two on the right, for a total of four. Once the scanner on the side of the room that he's in finds his two, he will need to go to the augmentation terminal and put his role in, and then the person on the other side will have to pick it up so they can do scanning as well. At this point, that's when we sent the operators down. You could start it earlier, but the problem is the operator has a timer where once he goes down, if he takes too long, he'll actually burn up, so we want to give him as much time as possible. Once this is complete and he's punched all four, a chime will sign and it's time for DPS. Again, a series of exploder shanks will also show up, so make sure someone is checking for those and keeps those out. You might even want to just devise one person for that role. The operator will immediately send his role up to another person trained as an operator that will take his place shortly. Then the scanner will send his role down so that the fuse that needs to be damaged can be confirmed. So again, you can't hold two roles at the same time. So that's why it's kind of tricky where you have to kind of send roles up to someone and then someone has to send them down. You just kind of have to time that really carefully. And it becomes really critical because later in a raid, this mechanic is used over and over. The big thing is you're gonna make sure that you do not shoot the fuses as soon as they come out. You're gonna wanna make sure when the operator who is down below gets that scanner role, and he checks, you're gonna make sure you're hitting the right one. So in the blow area, there are a total of 6 sparkly areas that are on each of the fuses. So there's 6 fuses, 3 on each side. So there's 6 of these sparkly areas. Again, 3 on the left, 3 on the right. We call those, again, looking from the front of the room, L1, L2, L3, R1, R2, R3, just to keep things really simple. The person with the scanner, again, will see it. He'll say, hey, it's R1, for instance. You'll go shoot R1. When you're doing that, when you do enough DPS, it'll actually then close that one and it'll progress to another one, which the scanner have to see. Now, the scanner has to be on the ball because it can be on the left or right side. So if we're doing DPS, what we found useful was Xenophage or, again, Celestial Nighthawk. Really helps out. We were doing in contest mode. I would assume, to be honest with you, once you get through this, one Celestial Nighthawk shot will probably take one of those out. So once you take out one of those fuses, it'll burn out, and then the next one will show up. And again, the person who's got the scanner below is going to have to keep going around to see what the next one is. Now, when we did this, we actually sent people were on the left, they would send them to the right. We'd send them back and forth because we wanted to make sure we did enough DPS. We were doing this during contest mode. As this progresses, my guess is what you'll be able to do is keep the people on the left, and the people on the right, to be able to do enough DPS and do it quickly. The other reason you're gonna wanna do that is once this completes and the DPS phase is finished, one thing that'll happen is the doors will close again. And once the doors close again, you don't wanna get stuck on one side or the other. So I think over time, that will be the correct strategy. My guess also is because of that, when you have the dedicated teams on the left and right and no one's moving around, you'll more than likely be able to one phase this. We were able to easily two phase this because it was pretty easy, even in contest mode, to do enough damage to each of the fuse to get 3 of them. Because again, what happens is you shoot one, if you do it quickly enough, you'll be able to get the next one. Again, I think it's on a timer. So over time, if you're not doing quickly enough, all of them will close up. But I think as you get to the point of being able to designate that left and right and have them stay in place, I think one phase is very doable with this. And again, once you're complete with that, you want to make sure, again, everyone's on their respective sides, send the new operator down as quickly as possible. So before, remember, we told you to send the operator down once the scanners had checked everything. Well, the problem is the operator now below is on a timer. So you want to send them down as quickly as possible and send the old operator back up. So what we did is as soon as DPS is done, we send the operator to open the doors, let the old operator out, and the new operator goes down there as the scanners are doing their work. So again, that just keeps the flow running, and it actually keeps the operator that's down below, the previous one, from dying. So again, that's the video. Really short, really sweet. Again, I could have put a little bit more detail. I could have put, you know, maps and things like that. I think every fire team's different on what they want to call things. I'm giving you kind of a guideline. Watch this video, play the encounter a few times, watch it again. You're going to, over time, adopt your own style. But again, I think perfect videos sometimes give the perception that you can watch a video one time and you'll be able to master it. And that's just not possible. You need to actually see it and do it to be proficient. Practice makes perfect. That's the video. I really appreciate your guys' time. If you like the video, feel free to like the video and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you Guardians in a tower.